Captivation. Captivation. How do you captivate attention? How do you grab attention? We're in an attention deficit world, right? Everything. You look at your phone, it takes you away from the real world. You flip over to Facebook, takes you away from your email. You get off the phone and you actually call somebody over here, it takes you away from your email and your Facebook and now you're calling somebody. And then you look up from this and you're talking to this person over here and there's three responses that are coming over here. We live in an attention deficit world. An attention deficit world. So, in an attention deficit world, how in the world do we capture attention and bring it to us when we need that attention, their attention on us for this little tiny period of time to make sure that we can do business or that we can cement the relationship or help things go better in the relationship and the relationship, whether it's personal, your child, your wife, your boss, whatever. You must have their attention if you're going to cause people to want to improve things with you, right? So you have to captivate the attention. And then you have to absorb them into your world. This is what the best movie makers in the world do, right? You have to capture their attention and absorb that person into your world. How do you do it? There's four basic ways. The first is that you can direct attention to something that you both agree on. Let's just imagine that both of you, this person, you and this person over here, let's just say that you're both liberals and you're both mad at the president, right? And the president right now, we're recording this in, I don't even know what year it is, 2017. 2017 is Donald Trump in the United States. So we're in that world right now. 2 years ago, Obama, doesn't matter, all right? But you know this person's a Democrat and so are you. So the chances are if they're active politically that they just hate the current administration, can't stand anything that's going on. And every day the Huffington Post is telling them that they should hate somebody else more. Promise. So what you want to do is find that thing, that belief, that idea, that ideology that the person agrees with you and maneuver yourself parallel to the person so that you can say something along these lines. So you have the television on over here, it's in the background, and all of a sudden it says, and today President blah 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 said this. Can you believe this? This administration has gotten nothing right in the last year, have they? Nothing. And then the person will go and you think your statement was powerful. Wow, wait till you hear their statement. Or if, say this is a conservative person and say that you have a conservative belief that you know parallels theirs. I'm very much a libertarian. That means I have a lot of liberal beliefs, but when it comes to money, fiscal issues, you can guarantee I'm conservative and I make Ron Paul look like a radical, okay? So if somebody's saying over here, you know, I don't like the way that we're misspending our money, I can sit there and agree with every single person out here, Democrat, Republican, welfare, Medicare, Social Security, Department of Homeland Security, defense budget, you name it. Everybody's spending way too much money. The only guy who needs to get paid more money is the guy on the front lines that's doing something for the Marines or the military. That's about it. Maybe my postman, he does a pretty good job. Deals with a lot of garbage. So maybe two people. That's about it. Otherwise, everything can get cut by 80%, and I don't think we miss that much in the world. Everything will be fine. Right? And so I can find something to agree with pretty much every human being that I come into contact with. So you want to get only to the point of whatever it is that you fully and fundamentally agree with the person with and get into that world and allow them to vent. Okay? Allow them to become angry with the people who are causing this problem. This is true with guns and church, Republicans, Democrats, abortion, anything where you agree passionately or disagree with them, right? The common enemy, right? Over here. So they're the common enemy, that guy over there, and this is you guys here. And if this is where things get really powerfully connected together. When he's the common enemy or she's the common enemy and you guys are together, that's where strong, strong connections happen. Lifetime connections can happen over common enemies or passionate agreements. Oh, I believe that we should have chocolate cake for dinner tonight. Okay, that'll get a yay, but it doesn't change the world, right? So we're not talking about dispassionate things like having cake tonight, which will be nice for tonight, but it's not critical. But your belief on abortion or human rights or civil rights or guns or handgun control or whatever, those are things that are huge issues, right? Those are massive, intensely emotional issues. Everybody has an opinion, and those opinions tend to be polarized very highly. If you know, or if you can understand fully without you stating your opinion, that person, you can actually mirror off of their belief structure. You can actually say, does it drive you crazy that there's not better gun laws in this country? Or do you subscribe to the idea that if it's not this, it'll be something else, and it has nothing to do with the weapon, but it's actually the person who's taking care of the weapon? You can communicate that. All right. It's a little more elegant and a little more difficult to make it work perfectly. But ideally, you're looking for the things that you passionately agree or the things that you find over there that you both absolutely abhor with a passion. Those things are huge connectors. They captivate people. That sentence will draw all of their attention away from Facebook. It'll draw their attention away from their email, from the phone call that's coming in. It'll cause them to put their phone down and talk to you and look you right in the eye directly, just like that. Number two, something controversial can really be a good idea as far as bringing somebody into your world. So I'm trying to think of a good example here, like property taxes, okay? So in other words, I'm not talking about like income tax. I'm not talking about the idea of, your income taxes really need to go up or down, all right? Now we're not gonna talk about that. That's one of those issues that's the first one I talked about, right? The passionate, but property tax. We all bought the house, right? We're all living here. And we chose to be here. We're choosing to pay the property tax. And we could pay less property tax by having a smaller house or a smaller piece of property or not having it and just have rent, right? So you actually control this. So this is controversial, but it's not a hot button because the person's actually in control of the outcome. So yeah, I get irritated that I have to pay property taxes. And if you talk about this, I will tell you, it drives me nuts. Every spring I got to kick out $18,000 and I am not happy about it. But you can't get too mad about it because you chose to live in the house. It's your decision to pay it. It's not your decision to pay the income tax. You just do that so you don't get in trouble, right? And you can get in a lot of trouble. So federal and state income taxes, stuff like that, you don't talk about those things. But things that are like sales tax, there's a good example, or gas tax. These are things that if you're choosing to drive, you're going to, right? It's a choice. You're actually doing it. It just bothers you that it's controversial. Is what it is, right? And controversy can bring attention to a subject and cause people to be captivated by you. So I can sit there and say, you know, Delta just drives me absolutely crazy. The airlines are getting away with murder in their change fees, and it's really ticking me off. And yet I pay them every single month because I'm constantly adjusting plans depending on where I have to go speak, where I have to go travel to, where I've got to go. And so I'm choosing to do it myself. Controversial, but not passion, right? Not passion. That'll bring people together. That'll bring two people together and cause them to put all of their other things down and listen to you and talk with you about their opinion about the same thing. And almost always on these controversial issues, people tend to agree with you, but they're not so intense that if they disagreed with you, that they would walk away or that it wouldn't cause the sale. Because you can be wise enough to always say this. When the person makes a very good point, you can always ask them. They say, well, you know, Kev, property taxes are pretty doggone important. And I know you complain about the fact that almost all of your money that you pay there goes up to Duluth. Totally get that. But you know what? If it didn't, all those people would live down here where you live. And you don't like people living where you live, right? Hard to argue with that. So I say, you know what? Keep sending the money up to Duluth. It's fine. It's okay. And the person made a really, really good point about something that I have a real hot button issue about. Kev, if you didn't have a hub in Minneapolis, you would be flying two stops to New York or to Vegas every single time you got on a plane. You'd be going Frontier Airlines through Denver to Vegas, true? Yeah, so yeah, it's irritating and it's gotta drive you nuts, but oh yeah, I suppose I can let it go, right? Controversial, not deadly. I'll see you guys here next time.